We are underway. Dogs and Eels at Telstra Stadium. Michael Vella, first man ball in hand.
A little bit of drop ball here and there. You expect them in their first game. Is that Parramatta go wide one more time? I think that's the difference about the two teams so far, that the Bulldogs are willing to use the ball a little bit wider than just around that ruck area. And here's their first penalty for Parramatta.
The first opportunity at points in this round one clash. And he's hit it light nicely as Luke Burt, the rebound. Oh, that could have been simply magical for the Eels. Corey Hughes to Sherwin. Second man ball to Stephen Price, looking to get on the outside of Nathan Hindmarsh. He can't. Tackle three, and Asta. Good ball to Willy Tonga. And after a nightmare month, finally, something to cheer about for the Dogs.
It was a great pass by Brayton Asta. Standing on the opposite side of the ruck, you can see how happy the Bulldogs players are. And Jamie Lyon. Unlike Jamie Lyon, gets caught in no man's land.
Azam El Masri for his first points of the season. After 13 minutes, perhaps it is unlucky 13. For the Eels anyway, it is 6-0 in favour of the Bulldogs. Working their way out of their own area. Sonny Bill Williams. Here goes the rookie. One on the inside, one on the outside. He does it himself. Inside ball to Corey Hughes. Fabulous scramble in defence from the Parramatta Eels. The captain has got a 10-minute rest. 6-0 to the Dogs, looking to establish a comfortable early lead. And Nasta! And Nasta! 10-0. The Dogs are on fire.
And he's made a statement straight away, Brayton Asta, in 2004.
Too good for Hazem. The lead is out to 12. And the roll-on really started and can be attributed to Sonny Bill Williams and that magical break up the right-hand side. And the big rookie testing the Parramatta defence.
Well, he's such a good player for an 18-year-old. I watched him play 2 weeks ago at the Gold Coast against the Dragons. He played enormous. And I actually believe, and yet you hate putting the big raps on players, I think this kid can be the best player New Zealand's produced.
I saw him in New Zealand playing down Huntley in a trial for an Auckland side. He was 14 years of age then. And I think he was already signed by the Bulldogs at that stage. And I saw him, I thought, he is going to, and he's away again, Sonny Bill.
The big rookie on the inside is Luke Patton. He will have too much speed for Nathan Hindmarsh. It is 3 tries in 20 minutes. It's the Bulldogs night. There are smiles on the faces, and why not? They are playing brilliant football, this Belmore-based outfit.
Oh, it's tremendous stuff. Stephen Fakes must be very, very happy. Now he's got a bit of a smile on his face too, Stephen Fakes. But Sonny Bill Williams going down the middle of the park. No one laid a hand on him. Drew, the fullback, the fullback, the Patton, Luke Patton, the fullback.
And El Masri is 3 from 3. They are almost keeping pace with the clock, the Bulldogs, 18-0 after 21, and some long faces on the Eels bench. Keeping in mind, the Eels are still down to 12. Sherwin again tries to chip. Thurston is there, but we will go to the video. A hint of offside.
Good hear there, the referee, Stephen Clark, saying we'll just check for the onside. Goes out to throw the dummy, little step up the right, straightens up. Oh, he's onside by a mile. Don't worry about that.
No problem.
Just have a look at it once, and that'll do us, Laurie.
Just a kicking game. It's a pleasure to watch. I mean, it looks easy on TV, but they would spend hours and hours of practice at training.
What about the high fives and everything? Oh, it's too easy tonight.
Our video referee is Phil Cooley. No issues here. It is a try. The Bulldogs 4. And it is time to step up to the plate. For the youngster, he should certainly shown signs of that tonight. El Masri with the conversion, 4 from 4.
He's a special talent.
They head back towards the rookie centre through Sherwin. Chip regathers. Oh, here is Sonny Bill good. Williams. Set up a couple and on debut grabs a try of his own. A superstar in the making.
I tell you what, that was tremendous. And that's the difference in this football side, Laurie, is the little number 7. He decided, I'm going to put the little chip over. I'll go through. I'll regather.
El Masri's toughest of the night. Ha! Too easy. They can do no wrong. 30 points to nil after 33 minutes. Looking for ways to lose. They've had 31% of the football, the Parramatta Eels. Price short ball, Asatasi. A couple in front, he brushes them off. And the Dogs will move out to 36. Try number 6 for the half.
Well, again, Parramatta had stacked all their defence over to the left.
El Masri steps in. Maintains his perfect scorecard for this evening. 6 from 6 for Hazem El Masri. That's evident in their missed tackle count, only 2 today.
Yeah, you've got to be able to work with one another, making sure that everything's doing everything right. There's not a right way to defend or a wrong way, but the key with your defence is make sure there's plenty of communication.
Jonathan Thurston cleans up the scraps, dummies to Sherwin, goes himself, and the Dogs are in for number 7. What a night. Their football has been fabulous.
It might be time for the coach to go down and sit on the bench.
7 from 7 tonight for Hazem El Masri. He is on a roll of 11 straight. So that counter starts again. Grabbing a crossfield. Simple run around. They are going backwards through Adam Dykes. Puts boot to ball and here's growth. The Eels collect their first.
Phil, want to check the onside, Nashi? I can't hear him.
Stephen Clark's the only one.
I can't hear calls.
Can't hear the video referee. He makes his decision, so he's going to call for the onside. I think it's all right. Oh, he's onside. You know, don't have to look at that too many times. Gets the ball down fairly. That'll be Parramatta's first 4-pointer of the night.
As we await the video decision, it is points for the Eels. And a long time in the coming. Strikes it out to the left.
Yeah, I'm sure the Bulldogs would be happy with their performance. Although Dykes are starting to carve them up a little bit in the middle of the park.
Peterson receives the offload in turn to David Vialecki. It's now just a statistic. It has no bearing on the result, but Vialecki collects the Eels' second of the night.
And that's where Parramatta have been strong over the last couple of years, out of that dummy half area. If you go a little bit too soon, the little man will dart out very quickly, go straight down the middle of the ruck.
There'll be plenty of heavy legs in the Parramatta jerseys tonight. Overnight rain here in Sydney, mixed in with the fact that this surface has plenty of sand on it, especially in the middle where the cricket pitch was laid for the summer sports. 4 minutes remaining. Again, the short side through Peterson, who finds the line. Little more than consolation. The man they call Sideshow Bob. Eric Roth and Wise Kataravada is his preferred wingers. Didn't want to leave Matt Peterson out of the side, and I guess an application of determination must have been spot on to leave a guy like David Vialecki starting the season on the bench. The result has been beyond doubt since probably about the 20th minute when the Bulldogs were near scoring in tune with the timepiece. It has been a smashing. Pearson bumping off one, still pumping the legs, tries to get it out the back.
Hutch is over, he's going to score.
Beautiful, Hutchie.
That puts a smile on the Bulldogs' face.
puts a smile on my face too. I love seeing unknown players get an opportunity and make the most of it.
And he's done that tonight, hasn't he?
And he has, yeah.
He's had 13 hit-ups. Tremendous work.
Azamel Masri keeps his perfect record, 8 from 8. For the wing free corner, it is full time here at Telstra Stadium. The Bulldogs, convincing winners, 48 points to 14.